And it's about a quarter after six, and time now for What's Trending. A message in a bottle was recently found in an Alaska river, and now the mystery of who wrote that letter has been solved. Amy Davies and Angela Goodell were about 14 years old when they were on a camping trip together in Alaska when they decided to write that letter. Well, they threw the IBC root beer bottle in the water, not expecting anyone, of course, to ever find it. But just a few weeks ago, a little four-year-old boy found it in the Little Cistina River while he was fishing with his grandpa. Well, Goodell and Davies, now 27 years old and both married with kids, they reached out after seeing a story about the discovery of the bottle last week. And the women say that they are surprised but really thrilled to know that their letter has been found. Davies says that it is just crazy because when they wrote it, they just thought it was going to make it maybe 10 feet down the creek, and then that was it. They didn't ever think that they would be seeing it again, especially in crazy Alaska weather. So I love this story. Messages in a bottle are so much fun. So I love that they wrote it. I love that the four-year-old found it. And it's just so neat that that they came forward. And so now the mystery is solved.
I am extremely amazed. Like, this seems like something straight out of a movie. It's something I've always wanted to do as a kid. Like, just find something so magical like that. And just, you know, being an adult now and be able to look back. How crazy is that? Like, you're grown up and have kids now and you can do something like that. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, very cool. It shows the power of social media. Now, if this was several years ago, you know, they probably wouldn't have reconnected and they never would have known that the bottle was found. But it does pose a question. I do wonder how many bottles are still out there waiting to be found, because you got to think that there's still several out there.
Right, exactly. In rivers, in the ocean, all over the place. And I love also in the interview with those ladies, they said that one of the things they remembered about writing that letter was that they were both boy crazy at the time. And so that was a lot of the stuff that they included in the text.
Oh my gosh, definitely something to look back on. Well, in times like these, a smile can go a long way. A daddy-daughter duo in Kentucky is starting a movement one smile at a time. Maddie has Down syndrome and is nonverbal, but it doesn't take much for her to communicate. When nothing else seems clear, it's Maddie's face lighting up that provides clarity for her dad, Michael. He wondered if Maddie's grin could do that for him. What could it do for others? Smile Project Louisville started with a photo in a Wendy's drive-thru in the spring of 2018. Michael said that he'd love to take a picture of them smiling together in that moment to say thank you. Never knowing a moment would become such a popular movement, now he travels around the area with Maddie, spreading hope and happiness, something that costs nothing. But the payoff is huge. At first, taking pictures of strangers throughout the city and now granting random acts of kindness, people started nominating people and telling the story of why someone needed a smile. Dad and daughter using a special smile to spread a message, no words necessary. Definitely, definitely, definitely a cute story. I mean, I know exactly what it's like to have a great relationship with your dad, and just, you're never fully dressed without a smile. I always say it's definitely something worth remembering throughout the years.
I love that. And they're clearly spreading joy, and especially during a time when everybody needs it, everybody can use a smile. And a fun fact for you guys, my camp counselor name was Smiley. So I'm all about the smile.
Interesting little fact right there. And I do say smiles are contagious too. So once one person smiles, another person smiles, it's just a chain reaction to help brighten people's day. So a great fun little story right there. Well, you might have been smiling this past weekend. The reason why? We are officially now in summer, and a small group gathered near Britain's ancient monument Stonehenge Saturday to celebrate the summer solstice. This year, due to the coronavirus pandemic, official celebrations were canceled, and organizers urged people to stay away from the site. Gray skies and rain prevented a clear view of the sunrise each year at Stonehenge. A collection of the standing stones attracts spiritualists and tourists to celebrate the longest day of the year in the Northern Hemisphere. The organization says it plans to reopen Stonehenge in July as the UK authorities gradually lift lockdown measures.
I'm sure that would certainly be an incredible place to mark that occasion. And, you know, it's a shame, though, that it's closed, but I'm glad that some people still got a little bit, you know, close by to be able to recognize it and enjoy the longest day.
Yeah, certainly. I remember I was in London just a couple months ago, and I unfortunately missed out on Stonehenge. But from what my parents tell me, they visited often when they were in the UK. It is absolutely beautiful, especially when the sunsets are hitting, and I can't even imagine what it would look like on the longest day of the year. Yep.